What's up, guys? Welcome back to another edition of Neon Trash. I'm your host, Tommy the Hammer. In today's video review, we're going to be checking out a movie called Deathwatch from the early to mid-2000s. I saw this movie many years ago, and I thought it was actually quite good. Very moody, very atmospheric, a nice sense of dread, and you know what, guys? I love horror movies that take place in a different era, a different time period. Check out the trailer, peep that shit, and when we get back, y'all motherfuckers are gonna know my opinione on Deathwatch.
In the valley.
Come on! Come on!
Of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
We have captured a forward German trench. We will hold this trench until we are reinforced. We must. That is our duty.
It's like a maze, Sarge. No front line or nothing.
There's something wrong with this place.
What are you talking about?
Why haven't they come back for the men? Why haven't they come back for the trench?
Oi, who's that? Sergeant! Can you come and see this? Stolitsky!
It's death, and it's waiting for us.
You want to kill me?
Deliver them from evil.
Welcome to Hell, Private Shakespeare.
Death Watch.
On the cover of the movie Death Watch, Clive Barker is quoted saying, "Death Watch is a finely crafted piece of work, subtle, eerie, and powerful." You know, revisiting this film, it's easy to see why Clive Barker liked this movie so much. There's a lot of barbed wire ripping people to pieces. There's a heavy reliance on mood and atmosphere, so it really kind of engages the viewer well beyond just, you know, simple jump scares. And best of all, the overall movie has this kind of like indie, low-budget novella vibe about it. I could see this being a Stephen King short story or a Clive Barker short story. So, you know, this movie definitely has a lot going for it in terms of classic horror. By the end of the film, it really kind of goes for the pacifist perspective, which is not a bad thing. That's where I'm coming from. So that might seem a little, you know, heavy-handed to some people, but, you know, we want to watch movies that we can relate to. You're not going to watch some pro, you know, war and violence movie. Of course not. So definitely the star of the show here is the mood, atmosphere, and music. The other star of the show is the actors. Most notably is Andy Serkis. Some of you guys know him from, you know, playing Gollum in the Lord of the Rings series. He's also played King Kong or Caesar in the Planet of the Apes remake. He's a phenomenal actor. I've always liked him as an actor in movies. There's just something likable about him, and he definitely steals the show here. He's kind of a villain of sorts, and by the end of the movie, he loses his fucking mind. And, you know, watching his character kind of deteriorate and descend into this bloody, you know, madness was, you know, quite frankly, fascinating to watch. Now, the movie itself is not perfect. There's a couple of undercooked CGI moments here or there, but you have to understand, this movie came out in like 2002 or 2003. So of course, you know, the special effects aren't going to be up to par. With that being said, a lot of the movie is, you know, hands-on prosthetics, a lot of real barbed wire, a lot of real blood squibs, and a lot of gory, disgusting special effects. The other thing about this movie that really kind of, you know, hits the nail on the head is the gruesome factor. By the very end of the movie, you've seen so many horrible body mutilations and people being eaten by rats and, you know, barbed wire ripping limbs off and shit like that. It's actually quite sickening. I gotta be honest, guys, I thought this movie, for some strange reason, wasn't gonna hold up for me. I don't know why, but all of those fears were dashed by actually revisiting the film. So out of 10 stars, I think I could award the movie Deathwatch a solid 6, 6.5 out of 10.